Is criminal profiling a real thing and can help narrow down the suspect? Profiling assumes that certain characteristics of a crime scene, such as the location or the victim's behavior, can provide solid clues about the offender's personality and motives. It's very popularized in films, but the truth is it lacks scientific basis and can be subjective and unreliable. There is no consensus among experts on its effectiveness, and in some cases it does more harm than good. In 1992, Rachel Nickell was brutally murdered in front of her 2-year-old son. The criminal profilers pointed at Colin Stagg as a potential suspect due to his proximity to the crime scene and his past history of violent behavior. He maintained his innocence throughout the investigation and claimed that his arrest was wrongful. Only in 2008, police finally identified the real killer, Robert Knapper. He was linked to the crime through DNA evidence. And Stagg's case became a controversial example of the potential dangers of using profiling and covert operations in criminal investigation.